riots. Riots is a very particular thing in law, and riots is a particular thing in fact. Political violence of Arab gangs. Now, I had the great privilege back at the time to meet a number of young men who were arrested at Cronulla. I won't say where I met them or who they were or so on, for obvious reasons. And I spoke with these young men and we exchanged some legal notes and so on and so forth. None of these men identified to me that they had participated in these violent incidents at Cronulla, because the perpetrators were Muslims. But they most assuredly participated in these incidents because the perpetrators were Arabs. This is a very, very important point. The so-called, and I use the term so-called Cronulla riots, have always been, since 2005, incredibly important to the multicultural industry. Very important. It resulted in sister suburb agreements, sister council agreements between the Sutherland Shire Council and other councils. It resulted in agreements between schools, agreements between served life-saving types, all of these sort of things to multiculturalise and intimidate the Sutherland Shire, to change not only the way in which it lived, but to change its self-conception of itself. The Sutherland Shire Council not only put forward all these programs of touchy-feely multicultural education for the last 10 years, the Sutherland Shire Council has now elected people onto the council of certain backgrounds who actually push for the multiracialisation of the Sutherland Shire and for certain types of development that are absolutely destined to guarantee its cultural change. One of those things is that they want to develop new precincts in the Sutherland Shire. One at Miranda, I think there's another one set down in Pioneer. They're talking about development at Sutherland. Things always connected to railway stations. Very, very interesting. Always connected to railway stations. And what they want to do is build massive developments around these railway stations, with new unit developments and shop developments and other developments. They actually say, by the way, it's sustainable economic growth. What it actually is an attempt to change the character of the Sutherland Shire by giving preferential arrangements and deals to these new economic precincts. In other words, the precinct down at Cronulla, which was the first contact with the floor, I won't say the first contact, I'll say one of the first documented contacts between Europeans and the east coast of Australia, Captain Cook's landing there, has become second place to an idea of First Nations. This seems to be one of the tricks of the Sutherland Shire Council. And my quip back to that is, whenever there's a First Nation, there must always be a last one. Actually, there was no evidence that alcohol really came out that day. But some people on our side, loose on our side of the fence, have gone back to these issues of alcohol. First they talk about riots, that politically, even if you're an absolute political shyster, you'd have to say never happened. But the truth showed that it never happened. It didn't happen that way. But they've restored the idea of riots, then they've restored the idea of alcohol being there that day. And then they've also restored the idea that the only thing that ever happened was the incident on that day. They're not looking at the totality of the story. On that basis. recognised what it was from our side. They saw it for what it was. It was a matter of ethnicity and identity. My concluding point is this. It is very, very, very unfortunate when some people decided in their mind to commemorate a riot. I'll put that aside for a moment. But to commemorate what actually took place in Cronulla 10 years ago, that they refused to address the issue of ethnicity. A couple of the participants in today's events who are allegedly on our side said that this whole thing is not really about that at all. One of the people said that it was a matter of, quote, uniting all races against Islam. And I said somewhere else, well, this is a remarkable concept, because how do you do this? And why would you want to do this? Where, on what basis do you want to do this? Reason? If you took Islam out of diversity as a chemical formula, you are still left with diversity. Diversity has gone on so far in Australia that you're left with this concept of diversity. You can't just abstract Islam out of this mess and think that the mess that's left is in any way cleaner than leaving Islam in the mess. These folks have done a disservice in one way by attempting to celebrate Cronulla from the point of view of defending a type of multi-racial diversity, and that somehow it's only the Muslims who offend this concept of diversity, which they say as some sort of Aussie faith that they're not willing to accept. Young guys should be commended to the nth degree for turning out there and putting up some abuse to the leftists, and it was garbage and turned up for abuse to the fascists and racists. And as one said, burn your flag, that symbol of fascism. Right? Okay, they're to be commended. But the leaders for organising the celebration of diversity in favour of a right are to be completely and totally condemned and driven out of any Australian movement that is patriotic or national. Thanks, guys.